So a warm welcome to you who is joining us on this wonderful Sunday. And I would like to start by saying Happy Canada Day, because we were not together to celebrate this wonderful day. And what I find beautiful is that God gave us, well, a wonderful country to live in. I don't know if you are like me, but I marvel every time, especially in summertime, to see how beautiful are the nature around and everything. So I think we have to be grateful to live in Canada. And summer is a wonderful time to discover the wonderful country in which we live. But I was looking at Jesus in the gospel, and he's coming back home also on this Sunday. But he's not coming back as a tourist, but as a prophet. And he has a special mission. He is there to announce the good news that the kingdom of God is is upon them. And so, I don't know if you ever experienced what Jesus did, because he was not very welcome at home. And sometimes maybe you live this experience of wanting to share your faith and not being welcomed by the ones that are close to you, like the sometimes members of your family. But Jesus, he continued to do his mission even if he was not welcome. And I'm sure that he's telling this to you today: take a stand and I will give you what you need for your mission. So join us in singing, take a stand, and just receive this grace of God for your mission throughout your summer with the members of your family. So take a stand. Take a stand, take a stand, it's time, take a stand. See, the harvest is abundant, yes, it's time. Take a stand, take a stand, give up your life, for the one I need is you. Wherever doubt is spreading, wherever doubt is spreading, come witness to your faith, come witness to your faith. And wherever there is strife, and wherever there is strife, be a prophet of unity. Here I am, O Lord. Take a stand, take a stand, it's time, take a stand. See, the harvest is abundant, yes, it's time. Take a stand, take a stand, give up your life, for the one I need is you. For the one I need is you. To be a prophet in Canada. So, what is a prophet? If we look in the Old Testament, we find the stories of lots of prophets, like Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and others. And they are chosen by God to bring a message, sometimes a joyful message, sometimes a more difficult message, to the people. And sometimes they even have to announce something that is going to come in advance, so that the people can prepare their hearts and sometimes change also their actions, because they're not always good actions. And so it's not an easy mission to be a prophet. But when we look at this, we know that it's not only a mission to tell something, but it's also a mission by their own lives, because we know that prophet, they influence just by what they were also, just by what they did, their choices and everything. Well, they influence the people around them. But who is the person who is influencing their lives? We know it's God, because God is the first one who is in their lives and inspire them, because they have been chosen by God and they are serving God. So that is really something, because they're not there in their name, they are there in God's name. And that's what's beautiful, is that throughout their mission, they are not alone. They are with God. And that's beautiful. And I was looking at John the Baptist that we had the feast not long ago on the 24th. And I said, well, just looking at his life, he was an original one. We know that in the Bible, we don't see lots with lots that resemble him. But one thing that is beautiful about John the Baptist is that he had a special mission. He had to prepare the way for the Lord who was coming, Jesus. And he had to prepare the hearts so that they would be able to receive Jesus. And that was not an easy mission, because we know that the people from lots of time, they were waiting for this Messiah. And there John is standing there and just announcing, well, hey, he's coming right now. And so it must be hard. It must have been hard to believe that. But did you know that by your baptism, you are called to be a prophet? Yes, maybe you didn't know, but I'm telling you today, your life belongs also to God, and He has chosen you to serve Him. And through your life, He has a special message to give to the others around you. Did you know that? You are a unique prophet. No one else can prophetize. I don't know if we can say it like that, but no one else can give the message that you can give with your life. That's why it's important that you understand that today. And you have the mission also to prepare the hearts to receive Jesus. Did you know that? That's pretty amazing, actually, as a mission. It's sometimes I like to say it's even more awesome than James Bond's missions, because we know that a change of heart is not easy and only God can do that, but you can be an instrument to change the heart so that they can receive Jesus. We say that you can do that with words, and we know word is powerful. But as Saint Francis once said to his brothers, preach by the example of your life, and if necessary, use words. So that means that your life has to be lived out of love. That's how you can be a prophet. Because we know that, the Catholic faith has something special that others don't have, is the love of the enemies. Loving beyond the limits, our human limits. Because we know that our heart is limited. We have a little capacity to love, but we know that God's love is illimited, infinite. It has no limit. And that's why to be a prophet, you have to love with this love. Not your love, but with His love. And that's when you become prophetic. And to live out of love, well, we have to ask that blessing every morning. Because as I told you, if you're serving God, well, you need to ask Him what you need for your mission. So maybe during this month, I know that when my grandma used to tell me that the month of July was the precious blood month. So I said, well, that's wonderful, because the blood shed on the cross, and that's the love of God, the infinite love of God. So why not ask Him every morning, just put yourself at the foot of the cross and say, Jesus, now fill me with your love, your infinite love, your merciful love, and you will see something will change in your heart. And it's to be able to love a little bit more than you can think of. And You will have many occasions, I'm sure, during the summer, because we meet lots of people, and the frontiers are opening, so we'll get to see more people this summer. And I would like to leave you with three words that will help you. Be present. Be present to the people around you, to their needs, and seeing if someone needs a prayer, or yeah, just be present. Second of all, listen to the other, because you will have lots of occasion to have conversation. So just listen and talk less, and I'm sure that God will inspire you what to say after. And marvel, because marveling gives life to the other. So marvel, encourage the other, say how beautiful this person is, and be grateful for everything you have. So we repeat, be grateful, listen, and be marvel. That's a good proverb, right?
Present.
Present. To be present.
Yes, the first, be present.
Yes. So I'm sure that by these three words, you will win some hearts, I'm sure, for Jesus. Practice these three words out of great love, and you will see Jesus is counting on you to be a prophet. Where? In Canada, where you are living right now. So take a stand. Yeah, take a stand. It's time right now to be a prophet in Canada, where you are living. And I will tell you, love, and if necessary, speak. Have a good mission. Jesus, thank you for calling me, calling each of us to become your prophet. And thank you, Jesus, for revealing how to be this prophet just by loving. And Jesus, through this refrain, we would like to ask you this grace to welcome your love, so that we could choose what is hard, what is difficult sometimes, but always to make you happy, Jesus, to show you how we love you, so that our lives could become examples for the other because of you. Yes, of love, oh, what would Jesus do? I want to do what Jesus would do, out of love, like him, out of love, yes, of love. Doing something I don't like to do, out of love. Doing something I like to do, out of love. Walking, smiling, praying, sleeping, out of love. Yes, of love, oh, what would Jesus do?
I want to do what Jesus would do, out of love, like him, out of love, yes, of love. And Jesus, thank you now for filling our hearts with your love. Spread your love in our hearts so that we could be able to love just as you love, Jesus. Through this time of silence, we open our hearts to you, Jesus. Jesus, thank you for trusting me, for trusting us through this mission that you gave us. And Jesus, we ask you to stay close to us. And Jesus, by this blessing today, thank you for sending us joyfully out of love for you, Jesus.
May God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.